गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन यू लिमिट्स ऑफ सम ट्रिग्नोमेट्रिक फंक्शंस लाइक फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल लिमिट्स एक्स टेंस टू जीरो साइन एक्स विल बी इक्वल टू जीरो. दीज आर आवर स्टैंडर्ड फॉर्म दैट यू हैव टू लर्न एंड लिमिट एक्स टेंस टू जीरो ऑफ कॉस एक्स विल बी वन. जस्ट यू कैन थिंक since if you put at the place of x a zero, sin zero will give you zero. That's why limit x tends to zero, sin zero x will be equal to zero. And similarly, here this one, second formula is that limit x tends to zero, cos x will be equal to one. Since if you put at the place of x this zero, you will get one. Cos zero is one. Okay, now next one. Limit x tends to 0 sine x upon x, that will give you 1. Very most important formula. Sine whatever is angle, sine theta upon theta means whatever is angle, if this is equal to in denominator and the same thing is tends to 0, then only it will give you 1. Okay, and similarly the fourth one is that limit x tends to 0 tan x upon x will also give you 1. So by using these relations, so many questions based on limits of trigonometric functions we can solve. Some questions I am taking from your exercise. From exercise 18, I am solving some questions. Limit x tends to 0 sin 2x upon x. First question is limit x tends to 0 sin 2x upon x. Sin 2x upon x. Think I have told you earlier sin x upon x limit x tends to 0 will give you 1. So by using this formula, since here sin 2x, but here only x is there, that's why multiplying and dividing by 2, okay, and see sin 2x upon 2x, but here x tends to 0, so if you, here 2x should be tending to 0, so multiplying 2 in both sides, multiplying 2x tends to 2 into 0, is 0, that's why 2 can be taken out. X tends to 0, or you can call it as 2x tends to 0, sin 2x upon 2x, this will give you 1 into 2, this is 2, this is your answer. Now question number 4. Question number 4 is now sine square 5x upon sine 15x limit x tends to 0. Try to solve it. How will you solve? Very simple. Just see. You can make it as limit x tends to 0. First of all, for this one, you can write it as sin 5x upon a whole square, means you can write it as sin x upon x whole square. So for square here upon 5x whole square. Okay, so that it can become 1 sin 5x upon 5, but here sin square 5x only, sin square 5x. But here 25x square is not here. That's why 25x square multiplying and dividing. So you can write it here like this. Once let me make it. Here into 5x whole square. Here into 5x whole square. Okay. So this will become 1 sin 5x upon 5x whole square. Now sin 15x. So upon 15x here, upon 15x into 15x. Okay. So this will also become 1. So what will become? Limit x tends to 0 sin 5x upon 5x whole square. Okay. This is. And this what? Upon limit x tends to 0 sin 15x upon 15x. This will also become 1. And into 5x square. Yes, there are the limit x tends to 0. 5x square means 25x square upon 15x. X cancel out. So this much. So this is 1, this is also 1 into, this is, if I put at the place of x as 0, we will get 0. That's why net value is 0. Okay, next one is question number 6. Question number 6. What is this? See, limit x tends to 0 sin square ax upon sin square bx. Okay, in the same way here sin square ax, so you require ax whole square, then only you can write sin x upon x whole square, and that's why multiplying and dividing by x. Okay, and here sin square dx, that's why you require dx whole square multiplying and dividing by dx. Okay, now see this total can be written as limit x tends to 0, this and this taken together sin ax upon ax whole square divided by limit x tends to 0, this sin bx upon bx whole square, sin bx upon bx whole square into limit x tends to 0, here ax square upon bx square means a square x square upon b square x square, this x square cancel out. So here it is free from x, no need to put the value of x, that's why this will become a square upon b square, and this sin theta upon theta, theta tends to 0, this is 1 and this is also 1. Okay, in this way its value, its value is a square upon b square, it is your answer, a square upon b square. Some other questions like sin x square upon x, limit x tends to 0, this question, this one is 10th, question number 10, sin x square upon sin x square upon x, now think, how will you solve it? Sin theta upon theta should be here at the place of theta it is x square, so here you require x square, for that one you need to multiply by x and also divide by x, means in numerator and denominator. It implies that limit x tends to 0, there are, this is one part, this is another part, so x into limit x tends to 0 sin x square upon x square. If x tends to 0, then its square will also tends to 0, so you can write x square tends to 0. Here it is 1, 1 this one, putting at the place of x 0, 0. This will give you 0. So 0 is your answer. So other question like, limit x tends to 0, limit x tends to 0, sin 2x plus sin 6x, sin 2x plus sin 6x divided by sin 5x minus sin 3x, sin 3x. This is your question number 12. See how we solve it. Sin c plus sin d formula, limit x tends to 0. Sin c plus sin d, 2 sin c plus d by 2, 2x plus 6x, 8x by 2 is 4x. Into cos c minus d, 2x minus 4x, 6x minus 4x by 2, that is cos 2x. But cos minus theta is still cos theta, that's why cos 2 theta means cos 2x divided by. Sin c minus sin d, 2 cos c minus d by 2, 5 minus 3, 2 by 2 cos x into sin, sorry, cos 4 x. 2 cos c plus d by 2, 5 plus 3, 8 by 2, 4 x into sin c minus d by 2, sin 5 minus 3, 2 by 2. Sin x. Now how will we solve it? Just see. These two cancel out. That's why limit x tends to 0. Sin 4x upon 4x is required. So sin for this 4x upon 4x is required. So upon 4x into 4x I am writing here. So that it can be balanced. And now in denominator, there is a sin x upon x is required to become 1. That's why x and x should be here. And rest, that is cos 2x and here cos 4x. Now see, we can write it as limit x tends to 0. Sin 4x upon 4x into limit x tends to 0 cos 2x upon cos 4x divided by limit sin x upon x into this cancel out 4 into 4, so 4 can be written here. Now see, this will become 1, this is 1, so it implies that 4 into 1 divided by 1, and this if we will put at the place of x as 0, cos 0 1, here cos 4 x means cos 0 1, so into 1, that's why your answer is 4, okay, your answer is 4. In this way you can solve some others. Some more questions I can give you. This last question. Limit x tends to 0. Limit x tends to 0. Sin 3x minus sin x. Divided by sin x. Same way, you can solve this as your question number 22 from ADG. So, limit x tends to 0, sin c minus sin d, 2 cos c plus d by 2, 3x plus x by 2, minus 2x, into sin c minus d by 2, 3x minus x, 2x by 2, sin x, upon sin x. Cancel out. Now, it will become limit x tends to 0 2 cos 2x. 2 taking common out, limit x tends to 0 cos 2x. It implies that 2 limit putting at the place of x as 0 cos 0 1. So 2 into 1, this is 2 and so on. In this way you can solve all other questions. Thank you so much.